time now for a look at your health. Use it or lose it. We're talking brain games tonight because it is truly important not to just play them when you're young, but also when you're old. And Dr. Mitchell Goldman from UCSD is here to explain why. Nice to have you.
Always good to be here.
So let's start here. Why is it so important to keep our brain active no matter what age we are?
Well, the brain has neurons, and these neurons make connections, and they only make connections if you're doing something. So by exercising the brain, you're forcing the neurons to grow and make more connections, and that keeps you healthier.
And we really see it in people as they age. If you become sort of sedentary in body, your body doesn't work well. So it makes sense that if you're not actively using your brain, that too suffers.
You know, absolutely. And even exercise, physical exercise, helps the brain get oxygen, but you have to use the brain as well. The biggest problem, Kathleen, is that 50% of people at age 80 and over are senile, and most of the people develop Alzheimer's. Now, Alzheimer's is a real disease that here in San Diego, we're really trying to get a cure for, but the best thing to do to try to decrease your mental decline is to exercise your brain.
Yeah, and there's so many degenerative diseases out there like that. We've put up on the screen for folks at home brain games. Now, these are some of the ways that you say that you can, in a fun way, stimulate your brain.
Yes, it's basically getting lost in a new task, playing a new and challenging game, and even embracing new technology. You know, my mother is 82 years old. She works as a legal secretary. Well, maybe she didn't want me to tell her age, but you know, she really didn't want to start working on the computers, but once she started working on the computers, that was something really good. So people that are older, if they start working with new computer systems, they actually can get smarter as well.
Yeah, so the iPad is not just something that, you know, you buy your teenager. It could be something to buy your parent
as
well. You
know, absolutely, because there's a lot of computer games that also help you, from crossword puzzles to Sudoku, that you can use on an iPad as well as on a regular type of book. So, you know, playing these games is very important, especially if you're just sitting around, if like you're on an airline flight or something of that sort. You know, getting this out and starting to do the numbers, it's going to stimulate you.
And these are some of the, I remember the Rubik's Cube, never mastered it in grade school, not going to attempt it now. And these are just some of the simple brain games you can get anywhere.
And they have many different kinds of Rubik's Cubes. This is the classic Rubik's Cube, of course, but now they have ones with letters and numbers and patterns. And so when you've mastered one, Kathleen, you can do another. But don't
you only have to get me one, sadly.
But don't forget about simple things. I had another patient came in today, Joyce, who's in her 80s, and again, won't mention her last name, and she plays bridge every day. And just remembering the numbers and memorizing and playing bridge is enough to really get it going as well.
So what are the three ways to stimulate your brain?
Well, there must be more than three, but the ways that we've listed down here are, well, I don't know if there's three. It's like, well, the three areas we said were get lost in a new task, play new and challenging games, and embrace new technology. So those are the three that we were talking about. But essentially, all our viewers have to do is just use it. Because as you said in the opening, if you don't use it, you're going to lose it. So just don't sit around doing nothing. Reading new books is a way. Seeing new plays is a way. Playing with your children and your grandchildren, that'll also stimulate you. You know, a patient of mine was in a nursing home, and she said in the nursing home, they're people actually, they do lots of different games. They get everyone together in senior citizen homes, and they play all these different types of games. You can play Jeopardy games or other types of games, and you get active, and that's the whole idea.
Well, it is some really good advice, and especially with the summer coming, get some good beach reads, do some of that while you're soaking up the sun. And thank you for the advice. I really do think it is a good reminder. I have parents who are getting older, and I think these are wonderful gifts with Father's Day coming
up. And you sure you don't want to try this?
You know, that always made me feel really bad about myself, so I'm just going to toss it over to Jen.
She'll try at the break. All right, you guys.